Hey guys, it is Pastor Kyle, and we're so glad that you're here on Tuesday night for HD Kids Live. It's 6:30. There's no other place that we want you to be except gathered around your TV or around your device and watching HD Kids Live. Man, tonight we are on location, and I got a question for you. How many of you guys have a pet? Raise your hand up high if you have a pet. When I was a kid, when I was your age, my favorite pet was hamsters. I had three hamsters. Their names were Vanna White, Spud Webb, and Dominic Wilkins. Those were my pets. I also had dogs, and sometimes I would have a frog or something, but maybe you've had a pet before. How many of you guys have ever had one of these? A sheep. How many of you have ever had a sheep as a pet? What is one of the most important things you do for your pet? That's right, you care for your pet. And tonight on HD Kids Live, we're gonna look at God's Word at John chapter 10, how Jesus cares for not his pet, but his people. He tells us that he is the good shepherd and he cares for his people. All right, guys, before we jump into the Bible tonight, I want you to think of a question. What is a popular job that you can think of? Say it out loud. What is a popular job you can think of? That's right, a teacher. Man, there are a lot of teachers out there. Hopefully a lot are watching tonight. What's another popular job? Yes, a firefighter. That's right. Very good. Give me one more. That's right, a construction worker. Very good. These are all popular jobs. You know one I didn't hear? A shepherd. Who knows somebody that's an actual shepherd? Well, for today, right now, I'm going to be a shepherd for a few minutes. But I want you to think, who in the Bible, what is a person or who is a person in the Bible that was a shepherd? Now, think back to the Old Testament. I can think of maybe three. That's right. All the way back in the book of Genesis, we see Jacob. Jacob was a shepherd. Who's another one? Raise your hand. Moses. Right before God calls Moses to lead his people out of Egypt, he's out on the mountainside and God appears to him in a burning bush. It says that he is tending and watching over his sheep. He is a shepherd. What about one more? That's right. King David. Before he was king, he was a shepherd. Sometimes we call him a shepherd boy. And we hear in Psalm chapter 23, if you've been in Sparks, you know this verse. He says what? The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still and quiet waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths for righteousness for his namesake. That came from shepherd David, who was a shepherd. But that's not really a job that we see today. But you know, in the Bible, God uses the idea and the vision and the picture of a shepherd and sheep. Now, there are sheep right here. There's a sheep right here with me. There's a whole lot right behind me. We see in God's Word how God is our shepherd and that Jesus ultimately tells us he is the good shepherd and we are his sheep. We are his people, and we are like sheep. Tonight, we're going to look in John chapter 10. So let's watch our video to find out how Jesus is the good shepherd.
Jesus told a story to the Jewish leaders. If a person climbs into a sheep pen, he is not the shepherd, he is a thief. A shepherd enters the pen through the gate. When the sheep hear the shepherd's voice, they recognize him and follow him. A shepherd calls his sheep by name and he leads them. If the sheep hear the voice of a stranger, they will run away. The people did not understand Jesus' story. Jesus was talking about God's people as sheep. The Jewish leaders were the stranger, and Jesus is the shepherd. Jesus said, "I am the gate for the sheep. They come in through me and are saved." Jesus was saying that he is the gate that leads to true life. People who come to him are like sheep who come to green pastures. Jesus warned, "A thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy." Jesus was talking about the devil, who does not want people to follow God. Jesus said, "I have come so that they may have life. I am the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep," Jesus said. "I know my sheep, and my sheep know me." Like a shepherd risks his own life to protect his sheep from wolves, Jesus was willing to die for his people. Jesus came to do his Father's plan, and he was going to die and rise again. The Jews argued with one another. Many said, "Don't listen to him. He has a demon. He's crazy." Others said, "That's not true. How can a demon give sight to the blind?" The Jewish leaders asked Jesus, "Are you really the Messiah? Just tell us." Jesus answered, "I did tell you, but you did not believe because you are not my sheep. My miracles prove who I am." Jesus reminded them that he is the good shepherd. "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. The Father and I are one." Jesus is the good shepherd. God sent him to rescue sinners. Jesus laid down his life for his sheep so they could have forgiveness and eternal life. When we trust in Jesus, we are his sheep who listen to, follow, and obey him.
So guys, we see in John chapter 10, if you've not grabbed your Bibles yet, go grab your Bible in John chapter 10. We're going to read a couple of verses. There's quite a few verses here where Jesus is talking to some of his disciples and religious leaders, and he's talking about this idea of sheep. You see all these sheep behind me? The people in the Bible, they knew about sheep and they knew about shepherds. So we might not know nearly as much, but Jesus uses this idea and this picture and this image to talk about God and his relationship to us, his people. And if you have John chapter 10 open, I just want to read a couple of verses to you that help us to understand who Jesus is, that he is the good shepherd and that he cares for us. There are three things that I think that we can get out of this that are real easy for us to understand. Over in verse number 10, it says this, "The thief," now he's talking about the devil, but we talk about that there are people that want to do harm to the sheep. A good shepherd is one who provides abundant life. He is able to protect his sheep. He is able to go in and lay down. He even says that he lays down his life for the sheep. We see this in verse 10. He says, "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. But Jesus says, I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." He's talking about there's a door and a pen. Like if you imagine if this were a pen and I was the shepherd, my job is to lay down in front of the door, to lay over top of the door so that no thief can get in and destroy. My job as a shepherd is to give them life and to protect their life. And that's exactly what Jesus did. The greatest way that he ever did that was by rescuing us from our sin. He provided salvation. The way he provided an abundant life for you and me is by giving us a brand new life. God's word tells us that when we turn from our sins and trust Jesus by faith, that we have a brand new life. He gives us this abundant life. So the good shepherd provides abundant life. Now the second one is this. Skip down to one more verse. In verse 11 it says, "I am the good shepherd." Now remember, this is Jesus talking. He says, "I am," say it with me, "the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep." Now, that sounds kind of like it did before, but here we see how a shepherd, a good shepherd, protects his sheep. Now, if you were a bad shepherd, you would let your sheep just run off. If you were not a good shepherd, you would maybe let the wolves come in or some kind of enemy to attack them or maybe a thief to come and steal them, but not Jesus. Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. Now, how does Jesus do that? He literally laid down his life on the cross. And the great news is that we hear that 3 days later, Jesus, by God's power, brought himself back to life. He came back to life. He laid down his life, but then he brought it back up. He took it back up, that no one else could do that except for Jesus. So we see that the good shepherd provides abundant life. The good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. And the third thing is this, the good shepherd knows his sheep. Now, I'm going to try something. I'm going to try to call out to these sheep, and if they're my sheep, if they know me, they're going to come running. Okay, watch this. I think they're going to do this. Sheep! Well, they actually came running. Sheep. So this is what happens. This is what it says in verse number 14. It says this, I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. Let's try it again. Sheep! See, they listened, and they thought they may have heard something, but they know that I'm not their shepherd. They didn't come to me. They're not my own. But Jesus says, I'm the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. If we are a part of God's flock, if we are one of his people, we know his voice. We hear his voice in the Bible. He knows us personally, and we know him personally. That is a good shepherd, one that gives abundant life, one that protects his flock, and then one that knows his sheep. Man, we have a good shepherd that we can love and worship, and we can obey forever. Jesus says, I am the good shepherd, and I care about my sheep. Thank you guys for being here today in John chapter 10. Maybe take a moment tonight to read through the chapter as a family and think about how Jesus is the good shepherd.
Let's sing this together. Sing, I was lost.
I was lost with a broken heart. You picked me up, now I'm set apart. From the ash I am born again, forever safe in the Savior's hands. You are more than my words could say. I'll follow you, Lord, for all my days. Fix my eyes following your ways. Forever free in unending grace. You are,
you are, you are, you are my freedom.
Shining light, breaking chains that were holding me. You sent your son down to set me free. Oh, everything of this world will fade. I'm pressing on till I see your face. I will live that your will be done. And I won't stop till your kingdom come. 'Cause you are, you are, you are my friend.
We need your love as it us parade. Whoa.
freedom, we lift you higher. Sing it again. Oh, you are, you are, you are my freedom, we lift you higher.
Oh, you are, you are, you are my freedom, we lift you higher, lift you higher. Your love, never ending. Oh, oh, oh. You are alive in us, nothing can take your place. You are all we need, your love has set us free. You are alive.
Thank you so much, Pastor Kyle. My name is Pastor Campbell, and let's just take some time to pray for your family. And I've got a challenge for you guys. Maybe this week you could pray for your mom and dad every night, or maybe your sister or your brother. I just want you to pick maybe one or two people in your family. Maybe it's a grandma, maybe it's a cousin that you haven't seen in a while. Just pick one person in your family that you're going to pray for, one or two, every night. Let's go ahead and let's pray right now for all of our families. Let's put our hands together, let's close our eyes, and let's pray. God, you are so good. I thank you that you have blessed us with people around us who love us and care for us. God, would you just allow for us to know that we love them and that they love us. And God, that we, God, just allow for us to have a great week together. And God, let us be committed to praying for one another this week. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Well, thank you guys for checking this out. We'll see you later.